Well, new video obtained by News Channel 5 investigates raises even more questions about whether police are profiting from the war on drugs.
It shows an interstate interdiction officer offering the trade to trade the Freedom Mother of two truckers for their cash.
And the DA says it's just good police work. But critics say it's a prime example of how the rules have been twisted by laws that let agencies keep the money they seize.
Tonight, News Channel 5 Chief Investigative Reporter Phil Williams has that video.
Here in rural Hickman County, on a darkened stretch of westbound Interstate 40, two California truckers will soon be given a tough choice.
You're going to have to trust me, or you're going to have to go out on a limb and see what happens once we find it.
Potentially face a criminal prosecution or hand over the cash that the interdiction officer suspects is hidden somewhere in their tractor trailer before the night is up.
Hey guys, it's in the back of the reefer, you just got to get to it.
Agents will recover piles of suspected drug money, almost $500,000, money that their agency, the 21st Judicial District Drug Task Force, will get to keep.
I will do everything I can to take that money out of the hands of those drug dealers in the cartel.
But DA Kim Helper says the two truckers who she believes were drug couriers got to walk without even being asked to name their accomplices because she believes they had not really committed a crime that she could prosecute.
The transportation of illegal drug proceeds through the state of Tennessee, from my reading of the statute, is not a crime.
You say you're not traveling with anything illegal in your truck, right? No drugs, and you're not traveling with any large amounts of U.S. currency?
The incident begins as a routine traffic stop, except in this case, agents are specifically looking for drug money heading back to Mexico.
You wouldn't have a problem if I searched your truck or your trailer for any items mentioned.
As the time passes, suspicions are aroused by discrepancies in the trucker's stories, but officers are not finding anything up in the refrigerated trailer known as a reefer, so the agent begins threatening the truckers with criminal prosecution.
Money laundering is what it's called, and it's a federal offense. The good thing for you is, when we seize money, we don't deal with the feds. We seize it ourselves. And if it ain't your money, and you say, Agent Owens, it ain't my money, I don't know how it got there.
He's essentially offering him his defense, isn't he?
I don't think he is, because I think he recognizes at this point that the transport of money just through the state is not a crime under our money laundering statute.
Does it not make sense that I'm trying to help you? Because he honestly can't think for a second that we ain't going to stay here until we find it.
He sure is making this guy think he has committed a crime.
Well, and again, as I've indicated to you, law enforcement agents use various means of questioning to get as much information as they can.
But if I have not committed a crime, is it proper for a police officer to make me think that I have?
I believe that officers can use a variety of techniques.
Here's the thing, all right? Don't talk to him. Just listen. Just listen, okay? Do you want to go home?
I sure do.
Then the officer assures the driver that if they cough up the cash, they will not be asked to write out their accomplices.
Hey, I'm not asking you if you have knowledge about it, and I won't ask you if you have knowledge about it. You understand me? All I'm asking you is, where's the money?
Throughout this incident, the officers tell him, you do not have to tell us where you got this money.
I don't even care where you got it. All right? I want the product. That's what I'm after.
Is that police work?
Police work to the extent that these officers, from my perspective, are trying to work with these guys who are merely the couriers.
But at no point does any officer ever ask, what's the name of the big fish in this case?
Right. And I agree with you. Should they have asked it? Maybe.
Finally, an hour into the traffic stop.
We'll come back. You sign these forms saying you don't know anything about it. You're just claiming it. It's not yours. And it's done.
It's in the back of the reefer. I don't know how it got there.
We're good.
The driver comes clean. A short time later, this task force will be $500,000 richer. Still, the DA admits she isn't completely happy with the outcome.
I would love to see our legislature make a change so that we can make those arrests on the side of the roads of these guys.
Now, we also found cases in the Dixon area where subjects supposedly admitted that the money was from drugs. Not only were they released without charges, but we're told that the video evidence of those stops was later destroyed.
All right, Phil, these guys are supposedly running drug money.
That's right.
And they can't be charged?
No, that's what we're told, at least. But I also talked to a Nashville prosecutor who was involved in drafting the state's money laundering statute, and he tells me that he thinks the law could be used to bring criminal charges against some people for running money for the drug cartels. Still, Kim Helper says she'll now ask lawmakers to clarify the law, something that the DAs haven't bothered to do for years.
All right. Phil, thanks. Phil's got another major piece of his investigation coming up tomorrow night at 10, and here is a sneak peek.
Hey, the reason why I stopped you was you're coming outside your lane of travel. I don't know if you're getting sleepy or you're not drinking or you don't.
Well, this video shows what one officer claims was his reason for stopping two Hispanic men with Texas plates. But what he didn't know was that we were watching from Sky 5 HD. It's video that's now prompted an internal investigation.